is your traditional Irish stew, yes?
That's right.
Gosh, I nearly dropped the lot then.
This is a traditional Irish stew and a very good way of using up lamb, because people are often asking me, whatever can I do with lamb, because it's not one of the easiest things to use bony lamb. Just if you're wondering, is that, there we are, thank you, Judith. Just put that down there so I've got room to move at the moment. There we are. Now, this fine beast is scrag end of neck and a little bit of best end of neck. And if you buy it, Judith, in the piece, you can take the fillet off. For them, what doesn't like bones, because this is a very bone, the cheapest possible cut you can get of lamb, and it's the New Seasons New Zealand lamb, which is very reasonable at the moment, and at its best.
Well, here we are in the centre of winter. Yes, you tend to forget that, of course, New Zealand lamb comes at this stage. I was thinking,
and there's a fillet that lies all the way down each side, down that side, and down this side, and you can, if you move it yourself, you save about 10p a pound, and you can use this for Irish stew. So to do it, you take, start from the end next to the body of the animal, and you feel the knife down. It's rather difficult. There we are. Feel it round the bone, like this. And then I'm going to have to do it. There we are. Just feel it, feel your way through. And really, I enjoy boning. The only thing you've got to do is have a really, really sharp knife. Can you see how easily it comes away?
I'm amazed at the amount of meat that's coming off that, actually.
Well, it's a relatively new cut of meat, because people in the old days didn't bother to take the fillet off. And it's a lovely piece that is totally lean. And for usually when you have this just cut up in pieces, people don't like the bones, perhaps, or my husband doesn't. That's how I've learned to use it. And you can also use the same cut for kebabs.
What's that white bit?
That white bit here is, you should trim that right out. That is the
spinal cord.
That's right, and it's horrible. It gets in your teeth, so always take it off. I give you that back. And so if you want to use this in the Irish stew, it's delicious and you won't get any bones. But I'm going to do the traditional one that has bones. So, for the traditional one, believe it or not, to be absolutely authentic, you don't have carrot in. But I've got a separate bowl of carrots in the oven because I can't bear to be without colour. I think in Ireland perhaps they don't mind it all white.
This is the dish you've used in TV Life as well, because of course all the recipes are in there, aren't they?
That's right. And you start off by putting, you need 2 pounds of potatoes, and you put those in the bottom of the dish. Then you cover that with onions. It's very, very easy. And I was trying it out last Saturday, and it was lovely. I could pop it in the oven early on Saturday morning and let it look after itself. I put a dish of carrots as well. Here we are. And so you've got, first of all, half the potatoes in the bottom, then half the onions, and then you put the best end of neck, middle neck, and the scrag on the top of it. Now, you've got these large pieces of bone here, and it's the one occasion that I let my children pick the bones up, and together with chicken leg bones, they really enjoy it, and you get every little bit of meat off.
Yes, there's a lovely juicy sort of taste about them. I know with these, I love lamb bones.
And you'll find that in 2.5 pounds of meat, you will get, of this meat with bones, you get about 12 pieces right over the top. Now, what I haven't done, talking too much, is I haven't put any salt underneath. Let's just lift this up. Honestly, it's just like being...
And they all cook at the same sort of speed, all right? I mean, it doesn't matter. One doesn't...
Not
potatoes don't take longer.
Because it's fairly shallow, Judith, and lamb is the meat that cooks fairly quickly. So there we are. That's the layer
of
meat. Yes, lamb is the quickest cooking meat of all meat. Pork, you've always got to make quite sure that it's at a slightly higher temperature and cooked through. And beef takes longer. After all, when you think of the animal, it is much more solid, whereas these ribs are very tiny and take no time really to cook. And then put another lot of pepper and salt. If you're a bit nervous as to that how much you're putting in the layers, you could measure out to begin with 2 teaspoonfuls of salt and a small pile of pepper, and then you'd be quite sure to get the seasoning right.
And spread it evenly as you go along, and then you...
That's right, and then 2 onions again.
Lovely big onions.
That's right. over the top. Press them down. It doesn't matter one bit that this is coming right over at the top of the dish, because it does shrink back.
And so you're getting all the juice you need from the tops, in fact, from the meat.
No, you do put, also you put enough water to come just to the top of the
but
dish.
No other stock, or
No stock at all. Stock. All the juices come out of the meat, yes, you're quite right. Mm. And then potatoes over the top. Mm. And for this, you cook it for an hour at 325 with a sort of a lid on. And then for the rest of the cooking, you lift the lid off and it curls up the potatoes and makes them all crisp. Mm. And I like to do it in a nice shallow dish like this. Then everybody gets crispy brown potatoes.
Oh, yes, those soggy layers underneath. Nobody enjoys those, do they?
There they are. Now I'm going to put salt and pepper on the top of that now. Mm. And pepper. Now, if you can just move that to one side, Judy.
Which is this?
Those two. Thank you. Mm. Just turn that one in. Mm. And I'll bring the other one out that I've got in the oven.
Okay.
And I'll put it in that place.
Mm.
There we are.
Do you want this in, Mary? Or
yes, that would be nice if you could, Judy. That would start it off. You put it in the top left-hand corner. And also, I've got some carrots there. Just a second. That's nice. There we are. Now, I've taken the lid off the carrots, purely because at this stage I couldn't get the lid. It's rather a big domed one and it hit the top of the oven, but ideally keep the carrots covered the whole time. And I cook the carrots at the same time. These are winter carrots and they take an awful long time to cook when they're as deep as this is. So I layered the carrots with a little pepper and salt. Don't put too much salt because the water evaporates and it becomes rather strong. Mm. And I think the two go rather well together.
Did you put any sort of foil on that initially? I mean, should I have put some before
yes,
I put it in the oven?
Yes, I leave it for now, but you should put a piece of foil and you should put water just about up to that. Mm. If you like, you can put a little fresh herbs in, or thyme as well.
Mm, I think of you as a herb lady always. You're a great one on those, aren't you?
Well, I think it makes a tremendous difference to cooking. And in the garden at the moment, I've still got fresh thyme, a little bit of parsley under a cloche, and there's always bay and sage.
Mm. These are very reasonable dishes then that you've done today, aren't they, Mary, really?
Yes, they are, using the cheapest cuts.
Mm.